Good morning class. Welcome again in your computer classes. We have already started chapter 4, which is charts in Microsoft Excel. I hope you all are watching tutorials regularly. So this is second tutorial. In the first one we did about charts, types of charts, components of charts. So quickly I am having a recap of this. So what we did, first we did introduction in charts. So in that we did like why we use chart or what are the advantages of charts. Charts are always more attractive than text and they leave a good impression on our mind. A person can easily remember data in the form of charts, but it's really hard to remember it in the form of text. Then components of charts we did. Components of charts, there is plot area, y-axis, data points, chart area, legends. These all are components of chart. Here you can see on the screen data labels, chart title, grid lines, plot area, chart area, data series, x-axis, y-axis. These all are what? These all are components or parts of a chart. Now the next topic is types of chart. In types of chart we did different types of chart, these many types of chart, these all are the pictures of charts that we are having in book. So now today what we are going to do, we are going to do all these types of charts one by one. So first of all we will take up column chart, and for that what I am doing, I am going to start Excel so that I can show you there how to create this chart in Excel. Okay, so how to open Excel, we already know the steps. We will go to start button, then we will open Excel from here. Now this Excel is open. In the previous class I told you how to create a chart. So can we create a chart? Where we have to go, we have to go to insert, then we will click on the chart that we want to create and then we will click. But chart is not coming. Why? What mistake I have done? Yes, we have not selected the data. So first we should have a data, only then we can create a chart. So first I'll import some data for this. So suppose this is a file that I'm having in Excel. I'm copying this. Now here I'll paste the data. Now this data is pasted. Now on the basis of this data I'll insert chart. Now first of all I'll go to insert there. I'll select type of chart. Suppose column chart we are doing. Column chart shows the data changes over a period of time or illustrates comparisons among items. Okay, so how we can create this column chart? This way. Now in column chart also we are having different categories. What are those categories in column chart? This is 2D, 3D, then cylinder, cone, pyramid. So one by one we will try each and every one. First we tried this. Okay, see there are different options, different styles, chart layouts also are there. So whatever layout we will select, it will be shown in that format. Okay, now again column chart. Now we will try to do 3D. Let's see, this is 3D. Okay, now suppose we want to see cylinder type, we'll do that. There is one more option of changing chart type. How we can change, we will click over here, we will do right click, and as soon as we do right click, change chart type option is there. Now we will click on this change chart type option, and from here we can select chart type. Now in column C, this is cone. We will select one, we will do OK. It's not changing.
wait. Okay, now here we will create that. Okay, suppose this one out. Again it's not coming because I didn't select the text, first select the text on the basis of this text. Suppose I want to create it on sheet 2. So I'll go to sheet 2, here insert column. Okay, again that problem, that selection problem is there, the text is not selected. Again I'll select the text. Okay, here then I'll go to insert and column 1. Okay, this chart is created. We can move it accordingly. Yesterday also I showed. This way we can move the chart from one place to other. Okay, now this way we have created this cone chart. Now we will try to change this chart type again. Chart type, suppose this one we have selected. Okay, this is changed. We will change again, change chart type. We will take this cone, this type. Okay, it's not changing. Let's try it over there. Change chart type. Now we will take this one. This is done. Changes you can see. Let's try on this once more. Why it's not happening? It should change. There is some issue with this. I'm deleting this. Okay. So we can do changes in chart type from insert also, as well as by clicking, doing right click, then clicking on change chart type. Now first we have done column chart. Now second, which is this? This is line chart. Now what is line chart? A line chart shows the different trends in data at equal intervals. It shows data in different styles of lines varying at equal intervals. So now we will try to create a line chart for this. First we will select the data. Now I am selecting data only from here. Okay, now we will go on line chart and see first option I have selected. This way this line chart will come here. I can shift the chart. Okay, now we will try to change the chart type. How to change? From here we can see all the options. In line chart we are having these many options. Suppose I want to change this to 3D line, and I'll do double click on this, and here you can see this 3D line chart has appeared. So this way we can change the chart type. This was line chart. Now we will move ahead. Again we will come to the insert. We were on insert. We did column chart, we did line chart. Now we will do pie chart. Now as soon as we click on pie, subcategories of pie chart comes. So what are these subcategories? This is 2D pie, 3D pie. Okay, you can see here. So whatever type we want, we will click on that. Suppose I want to select this one. See, this chart has come. Here it has come in pie form. Again we can change it by doing that right click, change chart type. Suppose I want to of this type. I do double click, see it has appeared. So this way you can change the chart type. Now what type of chart it is? It is pie chart. What pie chart shows? It shows one data series in the form of the comparative size of things that make up the data series to the sum of the items. This is the definition of the pie chart. Now after that pie chart there is bar chart. What is bar chart? Bar chart shows comparison among individual items. What it shows? It shows comparison among individual items. Okay, and this is also having sub categories like 2D bar, 3D bar, cylinder, cone, pyramid. These all are the sub categories. So just to create this chart, whatever I want, I'll just do click on it. See, this it has been changed. Again, if I want to change the style, suppose I want this way, and it will come in this way. So we can change the style, and bar chart is having subcategories which are 2D bar, 3D bar, cylinder, cone, pyramid. Suppose if you want to see this pyramid type, just do click on that. It has changed into the pyramid type. Now the next type of chart that you are having in your book is area chart. Let's just come on area chart. As soon as we click here, what it shows, 2D area chart and 3D area chart. Now what is area chart? An area chart shows the trend of values over time or categories. What it shows? It shows trend of values, means how the values are changing over time and category. So just do double click and this chart will be created. Again, we didn't select, so I'm just doing undo it. Okay, now we will select first. Selected. Now here, insert, select the text, go to insert, go to area, select the category, and as soon as you select, the chart has been entered. Okay, now I'll do deletion of the previous chart so that you can easily see. Okay, deletion I have done just to make this screen bit clear so that it's not cluttered when you create new charts. Okay, now we will do the next chart. How many types we have done? We have done column, we have done line, we have done pie, we have done bar, we have done area. Now we will do scatter chart. Now in scatter chart, what it shows? It shows pairs of values in scatter format. What is scatter format? Means fell out, spread it. Okay, so how it is done? Just do double click whatever type you want. See, in this way you can see the scattered chart. Okay, so now the next type after scatter, there are other chart types. Now in other chart types, when we do click, subcategories are there. Now what are those subcategories? We can see these: surface, stock, donut, bubble, radar. You should remember these names because at times I can ask question from here also, like how many subtypes this other charts category is having. So just do pay attention on the names of the types. Okay, so this way we can enter this other type of chart also. Now how do we create charts and how many types of charts are there that we have done? So quickly I'm going back to the PPT from where we started. Then okay, so this we have covered by now, types of chart, and in types of chart today we have done all the types of charts. We already know how to create a chart. This is a topic in your book, how to create a chart. This is also a topic in your book, how to change the chart type. So that I have told how to change the chart type. Now visual style also you can change. Okay, that I'll tell you in the next video about the visual style, sparkline chart, changing data and text in a chart, resizing, moving. I have told you still. Resizing I will tell you in the next class. Okay class, that is all for today. Please keep on studying regularly and keep on sending your homework also. Thank you.